Thank you. I knew I was going to be a musician when I was 10 years old. Okay. I really knew, but
for real, you knew?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, when I was 10. But I did. I remember at school, I was sat by myself, and I would listen to the sound of trees, and that's what I would do at break time. And then when my mom and dad had this argument, then mom took me out of the house when I was 10, and decided she just wanted to get out of the house, right? And there was ballet was in town, Swan Lake. Took me to see Swan Lake, where she bought a ticket, and we went there, me and my sister. And then I heard the music of Swan Lake, and that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to compose music. I wanted to be classic. I wanted to be, yeah, that's right, yeah. Swan Lake, the ballet. I absolutely love ballet. So I love ballet. And then I'm basically a classical musician trapped in a jazz musician's body, even though everyone doesn't think I'm really a jazz musician.
Thank you. Thank you.
my compositions kind of go through different growths and different way, and I'm always searching for new ways of playing my compositions coming from the way that I play bass, because my compositions influence the way I play bass, and then my bass influences the composition. So I wrote first for on guitar when I wrote for guitarists, but now I'm writing for guitar on bass. You see that stuff we're playing together, and I thought I'd love to come back to you, Marcus, because you were in the band a while ago, 2010. You were in the band, Prisoners of Strange. And then I was experimenting with toys and sounds and springs and all that. And loop machines. I'm trying to just leave all that stuff behind now and go into something else. Yeah, and that's what this project's about. Just playing the music without any, like, all that. I've done all that kind of stuff.
Sure. Okay.
And I want to play, and I'm interested in melodies.
Right. Sure.
Above everything.
Thank you. please don't. Deal with it.
No, just thought of them. Just get something.
Thank you. Thank you.
I know that people have said about my music, it's not very South African in a sense, but I think it is. It's just because that I'm influenced by different things that I hear. And I was very aware at school, like when I used to listen to how the wind affected the leaves and then what the sound of the leaves were. And then I would notice the birds looping. And then I tried to...
First thing you ever told me to improvise over was a recording of a bunch of birds.
That's right.
And I thought you meant Charlie Parker. I was like, well,
no.
Over Charlie Parker.
When I took him into my band, I said, okay, he has a recording of birds. It's your first solo. The second solo, he had to put his trumpet into a bowl of water. So I'm influenced by the sounds around me. So I hear a hardy dog, and then it influences me. So my music is very South African. And that's what I like about the music scene. There's so many different genres, and definitely we have a South African sound that's very, very South African. I mean, I just love the people here, and I think that's what makes a country.
Thank you. had you there. I played everything. Yeah.
What do you think, Rami?
I think it sounded great.
Thank you.
She gets paid to say that every time. She gets paid to say that shit.
I was happy with that.